Hello musicians, thank you for joining us. My name is Andrew Mercer, and in this short tutorial, I'm going to show you how to add some equalization or EQ to your vocal track. We're using Audacity here, and Audacity is real easy for using EQ. And for this demonstration, I just recorded a little bit of spoken word here, but you can do the same things I'm going to do with this, you can do with a singing part. This is just going to make it really easy. Be sure to share this video on Facebook and Twitter. There you go, subliminal message. Now, if you want to change the EQ, you want to add the EQ to a portion of this track, you could select it with your mouse, as I'm doing. You can slide your mouse over a certain portion of the track. Or if you want to select the entire track, you can click the left tab. I click the left tab and I got all of it selected. Then I go to Effect and I go to Equalization. Now, don't let all these buttons and sliders mess with your head. When people see all this, they go, I don't know what to change, I don't know what to do, I don't know. Well, this is really straightforward stuff. Let me just give you a little bit of a geography lesson here. On the left-hand side here is the low stuff, the bass stuff. And on the right-hand side is the high stuff. This is the really high frequencies or pitches. So, and in the middle, of course, would be the middle. Now, if we turn up these sliders on the low end, it boosts the low end. It boosts it. See, and you can see by the graph there, you see what's happening. Or if you find, you know, you can raise or lower part of the EQ by sliding one of the particular sliders up and down. Now, it may take you a little while before you get used to knowing exactly what slider to move to get the exact effect you want, but that's okay. Don't worry about that. This is a little bit of trial and error. But in order to help you out, Audacity has a few presets. We have some presets here to give you sort of the sort of sound that you'd get on certain types of media over the years, like a Columbia 78, RCA, 1938. And when you click those, it gives you a graph. It changes the EQ so that it will basically make your voice sound something like what it was on that media at the time. Anyway, let's just try it. We just chose one and we click OK. It changes the voice sound. You can see the waveform has just changed. Push play and hear it. Be sure to share this video on Facebook and Twitter. Now, if I go edit undo, it takes that away and you can hear it compared to the original. Be sure to share this video. You see, it really changed it. So let's do it again. Let's go effect, equalization. Let's try another setting. Let's go to, let's say Columbia LP. And click OK. Be sure to share this video on Facebook. And here's the original again. I'm going to go undo, edit, undo. Be sure to share this video. You see, so it a lot of the upper end, the high end stuff, the S's and the T's, are lowered, are dropped. You see that? They're taken out. And a lot of the bass is brought up, so it booms a lot more. And you can play with these custom settings that are already in here in order to get a feel for how different sounds are made, how it's going to play back depending on what the changes are. And you can see the graphs are quite a bit different for some of these settings. And you can play with these, and some of these might give you the setting that you want. You know, it might give you a sound you like. Don't be afraid to use what's there already. Now, once you had a chance to play with this and do try a setting and undo and try a setting, undo, then you can start manipulating. You may find something like maybe this acoustic setting might be close to what you want. So you click it, click OK, have a listen. Be sure to share this video on Facebook. Not bad, let's listen to the original. Be sure to share this video. Yeah, it makes some nice, it's a nice looking, sounds nice. So that might be close to what you want, but you might say, that's good, but I want a little bit more high end. So you can really bring up some of the high end a bit more like that, you know, make some changes. And then, you know, make some tweaks until you find the sound you want and then click OK and apply it. And before you know it, you're going to find exactly the setting that you want. So there you go. And you can save these settings too. Once you find a setting that you like, click Save As and just file it away so you can go back later and use the settings that worked for you previously. So there you go. That's easy. Easy, easy stuff. Nothing to it. Takes a little bit of trial and error, but that's okay. That's what it's all about. This is all supposed to be fun. Okay, if you like this video, hey, like the recording said, share it on Facebook. If you share it on Facebook, share it on Twitter. Also, give me a like down the bottom here. And be sure to subscribe. We have loads of tutorials that help you with all this sort of thing. so be sure to subscribe as well. Okay, happy recording, and I'll see you next time.